In this tutorial, I will show you how to simulate NEBuilder HiFi Assembly with multiple inserts in SnapGene. To learn how to simulate a simple assembly with a single fragment, then check out our other tutorial. To perform the assembly, go to the Actions menu. Then go to NEBuilder HiFi DNA Assembly and select Insert Multiple Fragments. In the new window, you can define and prepare your vector for assembly. If a file was already loaded prior to opening the NEBuilder HiFi Assembly window, then this will be automatically selected as the vector file. To change the vector file, you can use the drop-down menu in the top right. Next, select the desired method of linearizing your vector, either through PCR or restriction digestion. To linearize by PCR, simply shift-click on the two desired primers in the map view. The amplified region will then be highlighted. If appropriate primers are not present on the vector, SnapGene can design primers for you. Simply select the vector region to be amplified, or click within the sequence to define the point of linearization by PCR. Alternatively, to linearize with restriction enzymes, select the Linearize with Restriction Enzymes option, and then shift-click on the two restriction enzymes in the map view. You can also use the drop-down menus to specify the enzymes too. If you need to change the orientation of your linearized vector, you can use the arrow buttons here. Next, switch to the Fragments tab to specify your fragment files. The Multiple Fragments window expects two fragment files by default. However, you can add more by using the plus arrow at the top. Selecting the minus arrow will also remove a fragment placeholder. To import the fragment files, you can use the drop-down menu to the right, or use the click here options. Alternatively, you can simply drag the sequence files onto the fragments window. When more than one fragment files are loaded, SnapGene will ask you what order they should go in. To adjust the order, you can simply use the up and down arrows. Starting with the first fragment file, you now need to select the sequence you want to use as the insert. To do this, you can either select a feature in the map view, or you can switch to sequence view and click and drag on a desired sequence. Next, switch to the second fragment file by either using the drop-down menu or pressing the right button. As before, it's then a case of selecting the desired feature or sequence to use as the insert. With the fragment sequences defined, now switch to the Product tab and select the Choose Overlapping PCR Primers button. In the new window, set your desired PCR primer melting temperature. You can also specify the desired number of bases for the overlapping ends, or a range of bases with the desired target melting temperature for the overlap. At the bottom, there is also the option to regenerate or remove the partial restriction sites at the ends of the vector. Once you're happy with the primer settings, select the Choose Primers button. The resulting NEBuilder HiFi Assembly product can now be previewed. And by switching to the sequence view, you can assess the fusion boundaries and primer sequences. You can also switch to the Fragments or Vector tabs to rename the newly designed primers. Once happy, give the product file a suitable name and click Assemble to create the new file. In the new file, you can switch to the Primers tab to learn more about the newly designed primers. And finally, the History tab describes the steps involved with the NEBuilder HiFi Assembly to create this product. For more SnapGene tutorials, visit snapgene.com.